Great. Good morning and welcome to the 7th International Endodontic Symposium of the University of Southern California. It is a great pleasure for me to welcome you here today. I want to thank you for supporting us through all these years in coming and taking this symposium every November. This is the 7th one in a row, so we have established a tradition already here at USC. I want to thank the speakers for taking time to come here, some of them from far away, and share their knowledge and expertise with us today. Today we're also celebrating a very special occasion. We're going to pay tribute to two individuals who have contributed enormously to endodontics at USC, UCLA, Loma Linda, California, the United States, and far, far beyond. Unfortunately, recently they both passed away and left a big hole in our hearts. Dr. Dudley Glick passed away in June 2007. Shortly thereafter, in January 2008, Dr. Al Frank passed away as well. So, with some words, with some images, and with some comments of friends whose life were touched by these two individuals, we will try and pay a tribute this morning to these two great individuals. And it gives me great pleasure to invite Dr. James Simon, the Director of Graduate Endodontics, to say a few words.
Okay. I think Ilan wanted me to start because I did have the opportunity of being here at SC with Alan Dudley. I first met Alan Dudley in 1968. And you have to say Alan Dudley because they were inseparable. You don't usually talk about one or the other. It was always both. It was really something to behold. I was here in Southern California. I was in Los Angeles for 3 months before I realized Glick and Frank were three words. It was just so natural to say Glick and Frank. Some people said Frank and Glick. There was Dudley Glick and Frank. There were all kinds of variations on it. But in 1968, I came to California, and I also came to USC. John Engel was the dean at the time, and I asked him for a day a week at SC if I could come up and teach. And he very kindly said yes, and they slotted me in Wednesday. Chuck Rudolph was the head of the department initially, and Wednesday was the day that Alan Dudley came. And that was more fun. That was a real treat. That's where I learned. Alan Dudley kind of took me under their wing, and what we did every Wednesday, there used to be across the street, before they put up this whole big shopping area and everything, there was a little dump, a dive there that would serve pan-fried hamburgers. But they were, you know, hamburgers. They were big hamburgers, not like the thin little things that you get today. Alan Dudley loved them. We used to go there every Wednesday for lunch. That's when conversation took in everything. That's where I learned a hell of a lot. I came up to school one Wednesday, just to give you an example. We had a case that it turned out to have a palatogingival groove. This is in the late 60s. We didn't know what the hell it was. I brought the case up to school. I was, you know, kind of interested in it. We finally determined that it's a periodontal problem, not an endodontic problem. And I showed it to Alan Dudley, and, you know, I was quite pleased with it. I thought it was, you know, this is an oddball case. And Dudley said, well, I've got three or four of them, and Al says, I got five or six of them. And we discussed the whole thing, and I said, you know, gee, it, you know, maybe we should write this up. So Al looked at me and he says, that's a good idea. Have the first draft next Wednesday. This is the way it would go. One of the other things, I was fortunate enough, we decided to write a book. I say we, Al, decided to write a book. He said that USC should have a textbook at that time. And so we got together Wednesdays and on weekends at different homes. And that was a treat. That is something that, you know, I can never forget and I can never express. It was just an incredible adventure, actually. I also had the pleasure of serving on the board with Dudley. It was interesting. You know, Dudley and Al were really opposites. Al was a Bren. He was perpetual motion. Dudley was a gentleman from the old school. And Dudley and I were in the same room examining for the boards. And Dudley had a hard time with it. We'd have candidates come in and we'd ask them a question, Dudley would or I would, and the kid sat there with his mind in neutral and didn't know what the hell he was doing. And Dudley would look at him and he'd say, don't you think the answer might be? And the kid would look at Dudley and say, yeah, that's what I was going to say. Dudley couldn't let the kid sit there and not know the answer. It was incredible. Oh. We were in Chicago one time for the boards, and we went out to lunch. Dick Mudnick, I think, was there, myself, and Dudley. And Dudley was always playing around with diets. I think he had just gotten over his grapefruit diet. And we were there, and I had ordered, Dick had ordered, and Dudley says to the girl, I'd like a plate of tuna fish. The young girl looks at him and says, I'm sorry, sir, we don't have a plate of tuna fish. Dudley thought for a minute, and he looked at her. And he says, do you have a tuna fish sandwich? And she said, yes, we have a tuna fish sandwich. Dudley said, okay, I'll have the tuna fish sandwich, but hold the lettuce, hold the tomatoes, hold the mayonnaise, and hold the bread. She looked at him, and Dudley said, do you think you can do that? She said, I don't know, but I'll see. So she headed out for the kitchen. Just as she was about to go through into the kitchen, she turns around and comes running back. And she says to Dudley, what kind of bread don't you want on it? In a few words, it's difficult to just express the love and admiration for these two men. Those of you who knew them know what I mean. Those of you who did not have the opportunity to know these men, you missed something special. They were terrific. Thank you.
Thank you to Dr. Simon. Next, we have a special message from Dr. Louis Roseman, who is the president of the American Association of Endodontists. He apologizes that he could not make this event and be here with us physically, but he is with us spiritually, and he asked me to read this special message for the families. Butch and Sundance, Lewis and Clark, Jager and Richards, some of the most memorable and prestigious pairings in history, have been forged through the dichotomy of mutual passions and divergent expression. Today, we honor such a dynamic duo for their lasting impression on our dental specialty and to generations of endodontists who have been guided by their legacy, Dr. Al Frank and Dr. Dudley Glick. Combined, they served as endodontic educators in Southern California for nearly a century. These two legends used their seemingly endless knowledge to shape what was thought, what was taught, and what was practiced in endodontics at USC, UCLA, Loma Linda, and Cedars-Sinai. Their contributions simply cannot be understated. The American Association of Endodontists is similarly indebted to Dr. Glick and Frank. Both served as presidents of the association, predictably within 2 years of each other. Their guiding hands and passionate demeanor led the association and served as caregivers for the continued health of the organization. They encouraged board certification for all eligible endodontists, while also leading by example as diplomates. They mentored countless endodontists throughout the certification process and challenged their answers during written and oral examinations. Their innate ability to raise the level of endodontic discourse and research brought us to new clinical heights. Doctors Glick and Frank also were generous contributors to endodontic research through the AAE Foundation. Dr. Frank and his longtime companion, Terry, specifically made the foundation the beneficiary of a charitable remainder trust. The pioneering spirit is visible through every grant and research project made possible through the foundation today. I was fortunate to grow up in endodontics when I did. It was a real privilege. To meet people such as Dudley Glick and Al Frank was a special treat. Here were men that not only practiced and treated the entire gamut of what our population has to offer, but also contributed enormously to endodontics through listening, writing, and teaching. When you spoke with Dudley and Al, you had their attention and interest. They possessed that rare attribute called humor. They could laugh, and they made the whole world laugh with them. I yearned to be with them, whether alone or with their spouses. You knew they were always about to have a great time. When the two of them entered the room, their enthusiasm and energy spread. They were inseparable. These were the boys of the West. They were the pioneers of endodontic periolesions, endodontic surgery, and were present at almost every graduate student presentation together. Always together in life and in death, never to be replaced. I'm glad their memory lives on today to inspire others in our future. I'm certain that their memory and teaching will influence future students and generations of practitioners in endodontics. Luigi Grossman, President, American Association of Endodontics. Next, I would like to invite another icon in endodontics in California and far, far beyond, who was also a very good friend of both Al and Dudley. Please welcome Dr. John Engel.
This is, thank you, Ilan. This is going to be difficult for me. It was Friday, April the 26th, 2006. at the annual meeting of the American Association of Endodontists meeting in Philadelphia. Leif Bachlin, Craig Baumgartner, and I, as the co-editors of the sixth edition of Ingalls Endodontics, met to finalize some of the details dealing with the publication of the text. Is there a button? Thank you. Later that afternoon, Dudley and I met for a chat, but I did not reveal to him our decision. It was to be a secret until publication. Little did I know that that was the last time I'd see Dudley alive. 1 month later, my visit to his bedside at Cedars-Sinai was heartbreaking. This once robust, loving, dear friend was beyond my reach. I could only cry for us all. My last meeting with Al was at his home in Beverly Hills. Terry and Al and I walked out to my car. Al started to get in, but Terry explained to him that they'd go out later. Again, I cried. Well, Al turned to me. He put his arms around me and whispered in my ear, "I love you." Again, I cried, but with the thought that he must have remembered me and remembered all those wonderful times that we'd had together over the years. After the Philadelphia meeting, I returned home and immediately sat down and composed this dedication to two of my dearest friends. Thank you. I sent it off to the publisher, but little did I know that it should have been in memory of rather than dedication to. By the time the book came out, they were both gone. My first association with Dudley was in 1952. I was at the University of Washington in Seattle and was asked by Francis Conley, who was the head of continuing education at USC, to present a 4-day course in endodontics. Dudley was a junior dental student at the time and was already the USC star in endodontics. I think that year he'd done 53 cases. So he was assigned to be my assistant at the chair and show my slides. To wake up the crowd, why he occasionally would throw in a nude slide. I was so impressed with Dudley that when I was asked to return the next year, I said, "Well, only if Dudley Glick is available." After he graduated, I continued to return each year, and now the two of us became the faculty. And soon after, Al Frank joined us. And I can't ever remember having so much fun teaching a continuing education course as we with these two dear and very highly competent friends. I urged them both to specialize in endodontics, and they traveled around the country attending courses, spending time with important endodontists across the nation. From that time forward, they were on their way to becoming two of the leading members of the specialty. And as I stated in this dedication, they were Damon and Pythias, Al Glick and Dudley Frank. Professionally, this band of brothers, professionally, academically, and socially. And their wives, Ellie Glick and Terry Frank, are also the very best of friends. Dud and Al became famous locally, nationally, internationally, and yet remained the same modest, generous, considerate, literally lovable gentlemen they always were, brimming with integrity and with honesty. Their dedication to education at USC, UCLA, Loma Linda, Cedars-Sinai is legend. This is what endeared them to those of us most fortunate to have been their friends, their disciples, their students, their employees, and their patients. We only wish that the entire specialty of the profession had the same opportunity. Thank you. Oh. Incidentally, I have to put in a plug for the book. It's supposed to be here at this outside table at about 10 o'clock. And so you'll have the chance to see the new monster.
Next, I would like to share with you with some views and sounds a few things from the life of Dudley and Al. I was very fortunate to have the full support of the families. Ellie and Terry were wonderful when I kept on bugging them, coming to their home, asking for pictures, asking for films. And basically, they gave me whatever they had. We took some materials, scanned it, compiled it. I selected some music and then gave it to our photography master, Peter, to put it all together. And I would like to share that result with you, A Song for Life.
Ma non è questa la mia dimensione, è la mia mente, non è mai in pace, è sempre altrove, tu dove sei, la tua voce dove, senza di te, senza il tuo aiuto, che sarà di me?
Say goodbye for the summer. Darling, I promise you this, I'll send you all my love every day in a letter sealed with a kiss. Guess it's gonna be a cold, lonely summer, but I'll feel the emptiness. I'll send you all my dreams every day in a letter sealed with a kiss. I'll see you in the sunlight. I'll hear your voice everywhere. I'll run to tenderly hold you, but darling, goodbye for the summer, knowing the love we'll miss. Oh, let us make a pledge to meet in September and seal it with a kiss. Thank you.
lasciar la mai da sola.
I must admit that while editing this material, I cried, and not just once. And sometimes it feels good to cry. Amazing, just in a few minutes to try and encompass such a vast experiences, so many people that these two individuals have touched, students, friends, mentors. Just unbelievable. Next, I have the great pleasure to invite the chair of the endodontic department at Loma Linda University, Dr. Leif Backlund.
Thank you, Ilan, for this opportunity. When I returned to Loma Linda in the mid-70s, it was clear that there were two individuals who stood head and shoulder above all of the other well-respected, well-known endodontists in Southern California, or actually all the way from San Diego up to Seattle. And they were Dr. Dudley Glick and Dr. Al Frank. These endodontic icons were obviously not just local celebrities, so to speak, and local inspirational icons. They were part of the national and the international scene as far as endodontics was concerned. And has been pointed out, and that all of you obviously know, is that they both played a very important role in the development and the progress of endodontics all over the place. They were leaders in the AAE. Dr. Glick was an examiner and a director of the American Board of Endodontics, and as Dr. Simon pointed out, he was one of the examiners, and he was one of my examiners, and I think now I understand why I passed, Jim. Very kind man he was. From my perspective, the greater national and international reputation that they had was important. And I know that Dr. Rafael Miñana has mentioned many times how important it was for Dr. Frank, for instance, to come to Spain and help bring American endodontics to Spain, to Valencia. And I believe he spent half a year there to teach, which is a tremendous thing for anyone to take the time to do. And I know that they have been friends for many, many years. And Dr. Miñana, you know, is here to help celebrate this event. But probably from my personal perspective were these two endodontic icons stood out more than anything else was here on the local scene. They were inspirational, and they were leaders. And I can remember, for instance, when we had the AAE meeting here in Los Angeles, I think in 79 or 80, and Dr. Frank was the chair of the convention, and he invited me to have a small part in it, and I'll never forget how much fun it was to be part of an organizing group like that. But what stands out even more was the fact that these two very busy people who were busy teaching and lecturing and practicing always seemed to find time to come to the Southern California Academy of Endodontics meetings. And for individuals like myself, being new in the specialty and being new in endodontic education, it was a tremendous opportunity to be able to come to these meetings, the Southern California Academy meetings, and be able to talk to two people like Dr. Frank and Dr. Glick. Had a tremendous impact on us. And we were fortunate in having them here. Of course, University of Southern California can be proud of the fact that they were the people who helped establish USC as one of the premier endodontic programs in the country and in the world. But they also shared their expertise with the rest of us. And I'm very happy to remember that when Dr. Frank retired and wanted to spend more time at their beautiful cabin up in Lake Arrowhead, he joined our faculty at Loma Linda and came regularly to spend time with our residents and to teach. One of the ways that one can get a feel for a person's impact is to listen to what his friends have to say, and you have heard much already, and much more has been said and written. But I'll just quote two statements that illustrate how I feel about them, and this is expressed by two comments. The first by Dr. John Engel, who spoke already, when he referred to Dr. Glick. He made mention that he never spoke disparagingly of anyone. And that really stood out because from the first time I met Dr. Glick when he gave a lecture when I was in the program at Harvard, what stood out was, this is a gentleman, this was a gentleman. And so Dr. Engel's comment illustrates that. And then in terms of Dr. Frank, Bob Uchin made this comment one time that he's a charismatic individual who knew how to enjoy the gifts of life. How better to illustrate Dr. Frank's life? Their memory will live with us for a long time. Thank you, Ilan.
Next, another very close friend of Dudley and Al, who also works at UCLA and served as acting chair for a period at UCLA School of Dentistry and Endodontics. It gives me a pleasure to invite Dr. Ken Trabert.
I want to welcome you all this morning to the symposium. It's a little bit tough, having followed Dr. John Engel, a presentation like we saw, Leif Bockland, Jim Simon. But I'd like to share with you some of my memories as one of Alan Dudley's graduate students. You know, I want to welcome all of you here, as I have said before today. Both the Glick and Frank families, their many friends, and the numerous faculty, students, symposium attendees who have gathered to hear the latest updates in the field of endodontics. You know, when I began to write this short tribute, I said to myself, what can I say that so many others have said for so many years before me? Al Frank and Dudley Glick were two individuals who dearly loved one another. They loved their profession, they loved their families, and they provided our specialty during their many years of practice and research with the foundation on which we have continued to add some additional stepping stones to achieve the practices that each of us enjoy today. Dudley Glick gave me my first lecture in endodontics in 1969 at the Veterans Hospital when I was an intern. Both Al and Dudley later became my teachers at the University of Southern California when I went through my postgraduate program. And Al Frank and I practiced together after my graduation from the University of Southern California. And both they and their families have become lifelong friends, not only with my family, but so many of your families as well. For those of us who were fortunate enough to have been their students, they instilled in each one of us that excitement for endodontics that helped us reach further into ourselves and extract that extra effort to better learn, more clearly problem solve, and to treat each one of our patients with the kindness, the dignity, the skill, and the respect that each one of them embraced in their own lives and in their own practices. I think Hal Slavkin lovingly referred to them as biological brothers. As so many other people have already said, how many times have we heard either Al or Dudley tell the stories of being referred to as Al Glick or Dudley Frank or vice versa? I think we've all said that because we can't think of one without the other. I can vividly remember their daily phone calls to one another when Al and I practiced together. They spoke of patients, they spoke of problems, they spoke of their research, but they also spoke of how to continually make endodontics the specialty that we can enjoy today, a much better specialty. I loved and respected both of them, and the things that they gave not only to me, but all of their residents during the many years they taught together at USC, Loma Linda, UCLA, and Cedars-Sinai. Both Al and Dudley were endodontic pioneers, as so many others were at the same time. I marveled at their ability to do so many things so very well. They both served as great ambassadors of our specialty, and they provided a bright beacon that spread the concepts and techniques of endodontics around the entire world. They taught us quality, not quantity. They taught us patient care, but not number of patients seen. And the ability to learn from our errors in matters of not only patient care, but patient management as well. Both of them were people-oriented. They shared themselves with their referring doctors, their friends, their residents, and their patients. I'm sure that all of their residents can remember the numerous ski trips, the parties in their suite at almost every AAE meeting, and even an occasional basketball game. And yet there was always time for each of them to serve on numerous AAE committees and finally as presidents of the American Association of Endodontics. They both received prestigious awards from the AAE for their hard work and the years of service that they freely donated to help making endodontics the specialty that all of us enjoy today. But there's also something that sets them apart from all the rest. And that's their unfailing love of family. Neither one of them was bashful about expressing their love for their wives, their children, their daughters-in-law, and the many grandchildren who all loved and adored them. Al loved his boat and house at Lake Arrowhead, his water skiing, and he became elated as each one of his five boys became superb water and snow skiers. Dudley loved his tennis, his workouts, his visits with each one of his three sons and family members, and both Al, Dudley, Ellie, and Terry enjoyed their travels, their love of antiques, and the numerous lectures that Al and Dudley presented in so many countries around the world. For all of us who will continue to carry and keep their torches burning, we want to say thank you to their families for sharing them with us for these so many years. Hopefully, each one of us will be able to utilize some of the many life lessons that each one of us learned from each of them and will continue to enrich our specialty by the dedication, the enthusiasm that both of them demonstrated to each one of us. And so to both the Glick and the Frank families, we are truly indebted to you for sharing these two wonderful human beings that have given so much to endodontics, to each of us in this room today, and so many others throughout the world whose lives that both Dudley Glick and Al Frank have so greatly enriched. Thank you so much.
Thank you to Dr. Trabert. And as Ken said, Al and Dudley had many, many friends. And of course, the time is short. But one special friend is here with us this morning. And with his permission, he allowed me to read a few parts of a letter that he wrote to Ellie short thereafter Dudley's passing. This is Dr. Jake Weichman. And I would like to read those parts of the letter to you. It was written on June 28, 2007. Dear Ellie, it was very nice of you to call me yesterday and advise of Dudley's condition. I had to shorten our conversation because I was starting to cry. This is very unusual for me because I almost never cry. But since my stroke 10 months ago, my emotions have been very near the surface. I awoke during the night and all I could think about was Dudley. I have known Dudley for 55 years. My claim to fame was that Dudley was in the senior class when I started teaching at USC School of Dentistry. I say claim to fame because he was very well known in the endo circles all throughout the world. Leo Gruden, Al Frank, Dudley, and myself were known as the Big Four in Los Angeles County in endo. Dudley was the first dentist in Los Angeles to limit his practice to endo. He was a pioneer in endodontics. I remember teaching with him at USC. He was always very well liked by the students and always ready with his camera. We shared referring dentists in our practices and consulted with each other about some of them. One humorous story about a patient. This patient had a root canal done by Dudley. The patient ended up in my office for another tooth, but said that my fees were higher than Dr. Glick and returned to Dr. Glick. I phoned Dudley and told him that the patient was returning to him because he was cheaper. He was always a joke between us, and Dudley never forgot the patient's name. Dudley, Al Frank, and myself studied for the first endo board ever given, and we all passed. When we flew to the AE meetings, I would sit between them. They would go to sleep, and I would be wide awake. When we arrived at the meeting, they would be roaring to go out, and I would go to sleep. There are many stories I remember. I recall another comical incident. The graduates were having a get-together with the faculty at Al's house. Richard Feinstein called in an order for pizza, and Larry Nita, of Japanese descent, went to get it. When he gave the name Feinstein, he was looked at quizzically, and the clerk remarked, "You don't look Jewish." Al was a friend to me, and I loved Dudley like a brother. After USC, I saw Dudley at UCLA. Even though we didn't see each other socially very much, we considered each other's dear friends, and in 55 years, never a harsh word passed between us. I have many recollections from my dear friends. Affectionately, Jack. We have Dr. Jack Weichman and his lovely wife, Jerry, here, and we would like to acknowledge their presence here. Thank you. Al and Dudley had friends all around the globe. The passion, their interaction, just basically embraced the entire world. There were practically no country where they traveled that they wouldn't know the people in the profession. And I would like to call upon one of their dear friends from Mexico, Dr. Jose Pepe Oinik.
Thank you very much, Dr. Ilan, for inviting me to be in this homage to two dear friends. Due to the shortness of time, I have to read a few words here. First of all, allow me to greet old friends that I had not seen for a long time. I come here representing our Grupo de Estudios Dentales de la Universidad del Sur de California en México. It's the USC study group in Mexico. Al Frank was our only foreign member for many years. For those of you that are not familiar with this study group, let me tell you that it was founded more than 60 years ago by graduates of the USC Dental School with the purpose of improving not only themselves, but the entire dental profession in Mexico. They organized a yearly seminar that tries to gather the most outstanding lecturers in the dental field from all over the world. Al was our foreign representative in charge of inviting and convincing United States and other international leaders in the field to come and share their knowledge with the dentists in Mexico. He did this with great success for a long time, attending faithfully each and every one of our meetings, either as a lecturer or as our foreign member. He really enjoyed his involvement, and we greatly enjoyed him. He was highly appreciated for his knowledge and savoir-faire, but even more importantly, for his quality as a human being, his warm and wonderful personality. We share not only a professional relationship, but also a wonderful friendship with him and Terry that developed in participating in mutual family social events. We both loved snow skiing, and we went down some slopes together. We first met through Dudley Glick, also a very dear friend, at a meeting of the AAE in Chicago in 1956. He was still in general practice then, and he used to say that I was the one that gave him the final push into limiting his practice to endodontics. I had recently become the first one in Mexico to, after 6 years of general practice, limit my practice to endodontic specialty. We were real pioneers. And let me tell you, it was not easy, but eventually we came through. He also took part in the early stages of the development of the International Federation of Endodontic Association, of which I became president and organized the first World Endodontic Meeting in Mexico City. Countless generations of graduate dental students at USC benefited from his learning and transmitted experience. But he went far beyond his influence by traveling all over the world many times with Terry, lecturing and sharing his vast wisdom and tremendous personality. I won't say that we will miss him, because we already have done so sorely and deeply for quite some time since he fell ill with a terrible disease that robbed him from his mental faculties. Thank you, mi cuate, my special buddy. In Spanish, as we used to call each other, for your love, friendship, and wisdom, your spirit, and your warmth will forever live in the hearts and minds of the many students and close friends whose lives you magnificently touched. Thank you.
Next, another dear friend coming all the way from Madrid, Spain, gives me a great pleasure to introduce Dr. Rafael Miñana.
Good morning. I would like to talk a little bit about my relations with Ilan Dudley. It is indeed an honor and a privilege for me to represent the Spanish Association of Endodontics at this academic tribute to our admired friends, Al Frank and Dudley Glick. I was very fortunate to meet Ilan Dudley in Philadelphia in the fourth international conference on endodontics in April 1968. At that time, I was in my way here to USC with a fellowship given to me by the Spanish Del Amo Foundation to study endodontics. Ilan Dudley, other teachers, and staff in the endodontic department, as well as Dean Ingel, made me feel like at home. They were wonderful to me. At the school and in the private practice, I was eager to learn everything about endodontics, like many other Spanish dentists who came to learn perio, orthodontics, or prosthetics to USC. Ilan Dudley opened their homes to everyone who came through, so nobody felt lonely in Los Angeles. Since that time, my relations with them grew into a true friendship. Not only were they my mentors or teachers, but my fathers. Years later, at the annual meetings, the Spanish dentists used to come to the stage with a bottle of wine. At the AA reception or during the dinner, everybody was laughing and drinking together, and Dudley and Al, and at the same time, they asking questions, many questions about endodontics life and how to enjoy it. Life with a glass of wine in our hands. When the AA held a meeting in Los Angeles, Al Frank and Terry prepared a super party at their house for 50 dentists and their wives from Spain and other people who were attending the meeting. Everybody still remembers that party as an unforgettable evening. My whole family was there, and more than 20 years later, we still talk about that. Thanks again, Terry, on behalf of everyone. I'll visit Spain many times, more than 10 trips, and knew my country better than many Spaniards. Although Dudley liked France more, he was in Spain several times lecturing at the endo meetings. We call Al the grandfather of the Spanish endodontics, and he was an honorary member of the Spanish Endodontic Association. We were lucky to have Al at the dental school in Valencia for a 6-month sabbatical. Everybody remembered him as a good teacher and a very excellent friend. I cannot describe how much fun we had during his stay at the University of Valencia. I did try to have Dudley come and to do the same, but he couldn't not, and suddenly, years later, he became ill in the Spanish Mediterranean water after we had met up at the AA meeting, President's Dinner Meeting in Philadelphia. Their houses in Beverly Hills were home for my wife and me whenever we came to the States. Without having reservations, they always offered a place to stay. Much better than to be in any five-star hotel. The question was, where we can stay, the Dudley Glick Hotel or the Al Frank Hotel? We were always welcome. My wife and I are very grateful to Ellie and Terry for their hospitality and love. In the last few years, when I visited Los Angeles, I spent many days with them at the stretching classes. We had a lot of fun together with a large number of senior persons. Dudley used to pick up Al and I at the corner of Bedford and Elevado to go to the community center at Beverly Hills. There were nice days. Dudley was doing well, only minor pains, and Al was in good shape. He taught me how to properly stretch the rubber tape in the class. On the way home, Dudley went over when was going to UCLA Dental School, and Al and I walked around the neighborhood. At that time, I didn't know how that later on the walks would become a silent time of being together without words. Professionally, they were my teachers and confident in my abilities. I do remember talking about the way endo is done now with rotaries, MTA, good vision, etc., and how many problems we had preparing the root canals with steel files, hard like nails, silver amalgam in the retrofills, a lot of x-rays. They used to say, how easy is endodontics now? At the beginning of my career as an endodontist, Al Frank persuaded me to go back to Spain, where at that time I was the first dentist in Europe to limit my practice to endodontics, instead of accepting an invitation to become part of the staff at USC. They also persuaded me to become a member of the AAE, and I was later made an honorary member of my beloved American Association of Endodontics, thanks to their advice and encouragement. Al and Dudley were true gentlemen who loved their families, enjoyed life, and more than that, practiced and taught endodontics to more people than we can count. Thanks to Ilan Rotstein, Jimmy Simon, and everybody at USC who worked on this event to honor two teachers who love endodontics. In closing, with my broken English, I would like to share what President Kennedy said in one of the speeches. A nation reveals itself not only by the men it produces, but also by the men it honors, the men it remembers. Thanks, Al. Thanks, Terry. Thanks, Dudley. Thanks, Ellie. From the moment I met you, I never walked alone in my endodontic career. Thank you.
Thank you, Ilan, to propose me and to give me the opportunity and the honor to say some words on Dudley and all. They passed away on the same year, and it's not hazardous. They were like two twins brother, and Terry and Haley the same. Always together, they have also together the sense and the image of love. Dudley alone was friend of France and friend from the French Endodontic Society. They received the SFE Louis I. Grossman Award. And in 1986, it was the first time I met Dudley. As you know, every year in the American Association of Endodontist Association, the French Society organized a party. And in 1986, I was for sure in the party. At this time, I didn't speak in any word in English. And I was a young practitioner just finishing my military service. And I was in this party. And in this party, I saw all the big name of endodontics. All my books on the desk are there. Dudley Glick, Al Frank, James Simon, John Engel were there, Noah Shivian, Don Arends. And so, and I had very big eyes. I was totally fascinated. And I take a lot of pictures. And Dudley came, and because I don't speak English, he speak with me in French. And he say, please, give me your camera. Stop to take many pictures. You have to be in the pictures. And he take a chair, climb on the chair, and take some picture from me and other people. And I was fascinated because in France, all the teachers are very strict, very no humor and so. And he was laughing, smiling, and very pleasant, and at the level of his, like a student I was. And since this time, we became very, very close and very friend. Another way, it was in 1989, it was the meeting in Anaheim, and I did my first table clinic. And at this time, too, I didn't speak English, and I learned my table clinic like, parrot fashion. And Dudley was there, and I remember I spoke about composite restoration, traumatized teeth, and I spoke about the bevel, and I remember, like yesterday, I spoke about the enamel bevel. And Dudley say, what's enamel bevel? Enamel. I say, yes, perhaps, enamel bevel. And it was always, until this time, every time, he supports me. And when I was in the American Association of Endodontics for table clinics, poster session after LAS and full session presentation, he was still there. And very often with all Frank too and Ellie, they were there. And Terry too. So they support me a lot. And I want to thank you so much because they helped me a lot for that. 1990. Dudley Glick comes very often in Europe, and he came in Paris. And when he came in Paris in 1990, we have Jean, my first son, and Dudley and Ali come in our apartment, and Dudley bring him a puppet. And I say, why a puppet? Because it's a boy, and normally puppet is for a girl. And he say, no. And I remember the puppet properly, you remember, it was blue with red hairs. And he said, no, it's his first American girlfriend. And I don't know if it's because of that, but now Jean is 18 and he loves girls more than studies. Perhaps it's Dudley's fault, because very early he gave him the passion for all the girls. Also with Dudley, we share a passion for the wine, the very good wine. And every time when he came in France or when I come in the United States, I bring some French wine, and him, he bring me some California wine. So I'm now an expert of Jordan, Sylvan, Oak, and so. And that Dudley was my American wine dealer. So Dudley was more than a friend. He was like Dudley and Haley, a member of my family. My American family. And I'm supposed to go in Orlando in the next American Association of Endodontics meeting, and I think the meeting will be never without Dudley and all. All and Glick, you miss me. You give me the sense of life and the sense of professional responsibility. We have a French expression in France, we say you have the earth on the hand. And you will stay in my heart. So for you, Ellie and Terry, I want to give you back all the energy they gave me and all my love. Thank you.
Well, as you know, we spoke about Al and Dudley. However, behind every successful man, there are very, very successful and encouraging women. And we would like to acknowledge both Terry and Ellie for the wonderful gift that you gave us all. Thank you so much.